up, guys? Welcome back to the channel. So today we'll be doing a little study, well not study, but test, if soft mounting your motors really work for reducing vibrations that are received by your FC through the frame. So basically, I've been noticing and reading on Reddit, on Facebook, that in different forums like RC groups, that soft mounting your motors helps reduce the vibrations. Obviously, there might be some truth to it. I mean, you know, for our cars, vehicles, all the engines are soft mounted on rubber mounts, basically because the engine is shaking and, you know, the crankshaft inside is rotating. They're soft mounted to the chassis or the frame of the vehicle, the car, to reduce the vibrations that you can feel inside the vehicle. So it might work for our quads as well. And we're going to be doing a regular Joe test today to see if it actually works. Obviously, I'm not a sponsored pilot. I'm not a super pro pilot. I'm just a regular Joe flying FPV, and I see most of you guys are too. And this is just a way for me to show you guys that, you know, a regular Joe testing a theory, basically, if it works or not, and see if, you know, what the hype is about. So what I'm gonna be doing is using these little pieces of foam that I think I got from Emax Motors from a friend's build. I have four pieces here, obviously, for four motors. They're about maybe 2 mil thick, 2 millimeters. Okay, hopefully that focuses. Anyway, I'm gonna be mounting these motors. I mean, the motors on these things. I'm not gonna be using electrical tape because, first of all, I don't have electrical tape right now. But I think the foam will be a better insulator, or I'm sorry, not a better insulator, but a better medium for reducing the vibrations. Anyway, this is the quad that we'll be using. It's an old quad I've had for maybe, I don't know, about 6-8 months now. It's called the Snipe, and it's produced by a local guy here in the Philippines. And it is, I've been using it for racing, and, you know, so far it's been doing me good. I've placed in a couple of races, which is all right. I mean, not first place, but it's serving me well. No bad habits. I like this quad. And the thing is, I'm a firm believer in the saying that if it ain't broken, don't fix it. So obviously this has served me well, so nothing's broken. And when I set this up 6 or 8 months ago, I think, the FC is still my very first FC. For some reason, it has survived through, I think, 3 or 4 quads now. I just transferred it over to this body, to this frame. It's a Nace Rev 5 running Beta Flight 216, I believe. So yeah, it's really old because I know now Beta Flight is running 3 or 3.1, I think. And the ESCs are, I don't even remember what they are. I think they're DYS 20 something, not the SN20s, but I think X something 20s. So they're 20 amp ESCs running BL Heli 13.1, which is obviously an old firmware as well. I didn't bother upgrading the firmware or the hardware because, like I said, it's been running fine for me. The motors are F40 T motors. I think these are the V2s. F40 2500 kV. Hopefully that focuses on the camera for you. But anyway, those are the motors. And what we'll be doing is just connecting this up to Betaflight or CleanFlight GUI for that matter, and just going to the motors tab and then running the motors at first without the foam to see how much vibration is getting, the FC is getting from the motors. In the motors tab, there's a option there that you can see in real time how much vibration the motors are causing or producing to the FC, for the FC. And then obviously we'll be mounting the motors on these pieces of foam, and do a before and after test, before and after comparison, and see how it affects, you know, the vibrations for the FC. So we'll just connect it to Betaflight for now, and then to CleanFlight for now, and see how the motor stab do. All right, so what we have here is the quad, and it's connected to my PC. What I'm going to be doing is, to make the test a bit consistent, is keep the quad in the same spot here, which is here, and not moving it at all, except for when I do the soft mount. Obviously, I'm going to have to soft mount the motors and then put it back in the same spot, so we have a pretty not say 100% accurate, at least we have the same spot so it doesn't affect the results, okay? So this is the before. Okay, let me just connect to clean flight right now. So okay, we're in clean flight and we are in motors. Okay, let me just zoom in for you guys. Okay, so now we're connected to clean flight. Obviously, I can't connect to Betaflight because I have a Betaflight 216. I can't connect to the Betaflight GUI. Anyway, this is the motors tab, and you can see here the graph, which I will arm the motors right now, slowly increasing. Okay, right now it's at 10. The value is at 1100 RPM or 1100 PWM signal anyway. See the vibrations here? 1100, that was 1100, will go to about 1.5, which is mid throttle. There, I am at 1.5, which is mid throttle. See the vibrations? And lastly, full throttle. That is the vibrations for full throttle. Alright? So now we'll be doing the soft mounting for the motors. I will be back in a while. I'll just soft mount the motors and doing this test again. So yeah, I forgot to add. I've noticed that when I did this test with this quad without the props off, obviously, that it twitches around mid-throttle. So this is still without the foam pads under the motors. The motors are not soft mounted yet. So I'll show you the twitch right now. So I'll arm it. Okay, now I'm ramping up the throttle to now 1/3. One, there. That's about half throttle. See it twitching? There, it's really bad. The throttle is about almost half throttle. Alright, so we'll see if the soft mounting cures that. If obviously it disappears, then that's a good sign, I think. Alright. So now we're done with putting the foam underneath the motor. So hopefully you can see those. Let's try to make the camera focus here. Come on. There you go. So there's the foam. You can see all the motors now have the soft mount foam. Let's see if the twitch is gone. The one we had before. So if the twitch disappears, that will be a good sign. So, radio's armed. I mean, quad is armed. Alright, 1100 first when I arm. Yeah. Going up to half throttle or almost half throttle where the twitch was before. Oh, wow. Okay, I'm at the same exact setting. If you can see here in the throttle. Half throttle almost. I don't have any twitching at all. Half throttle, no twitching still. It's a bit there on full throttle. Okay. So that twitching you were seeing earlier was the quad, I think, fail-safing because my radio is too near. But anyway, and then quickly recovering the signal. But as you've seen, there's no twitch at the same throttle position where we saw it before, where it was almost half throttle and the quad was twitching badly. So now let's connect it to the clean flight GUI and see on the motors tab how bad the vibrations are, how if they improve at all. Okay, be back in a second. Okay, as you can see here, we have the quad in the exact same position as we had it earlier. Same surface, so we're not introducing anything else to the quad except for the foam underneath the motors. Now we are connecting to CleanFlight, and we'll go to the motors tab and try the same settings we had earlier. 1100 first for the motor signal, and then 1500, and then full throttle. And then we'll see if the graph is, we'll do a side-by-side of the graphs of the before and after to see if it has improved. Let me just zoom into the graphs right now. All right, so we're ready. 1100 first. Okay, that's at 1100. Now half throttle or 1500. All right, that is at 1500. And then full throttle. Alright, so that concludes the soft mounting motors test that we have. You've seen the twitch side-by-side video. My quad had a twitch at around half throttle or almost half throttle. It was twitching badly and it was clearly gone when I soft mounted the motors. As far as the graphs go on the CleanFlight GUI, they're very close to each other. The side-by-side, you can go back and review. I think, if I'm not mistaken, the resolution on the GUI, on the graph, is not that... I left it at stock. I didn't change anything of the resolution on the resolution for the graphs. So, it might not have reflected it accurately, but generally speaking, side-by-side, if you pause the video, go back to the graphs and pause the video, you can see that the soft mounted motors have a bit less of vibration compared to the if the motors are directly mounted to the frame. It's just not much that you can see in the graph. Maybe it's just because, like I said, I didn't adjust the resolution. But for me, the practical application that you can see physically, you can see it with your own eyes, not have to rely on a graph, is the twitching of the quad, of my quad that it had at mid throttle. So if it removes that twitching, that's all great, that's all good for me. Somehow, maybe I might feel it in flight or I might see it in flight that it's not twitching. To be honest, to be perfectly honest, I haven't felt the quad twitch at that same half throttle when I'm flying. But if I can see it on the ground, then maybe I'm just not sensitive enough to feel it in the air. But yeah, so that's my conclusion. I think it works. You know, you have nothing to lose if you have that spare foam lying around for your motors, or even electrical tape for that matter. Then by all means, do it. If your quad has a problem twitching or with bad vibrations, obviously PIDs will come into account. I didn't change any of those to keep it at an equal testing level. So. Yeah, if you like my video, and comment, like, subscribe, and ask away at the comment section below. I read those. I try to answer everything. And thanks and happy flying, you guys.